Hi there. I want to look today at comparing and ordering rational numbers. And remember, a rational number is simply any number that can be written as a fraction. So you'll see here I have these four fractions that I want to order. Now, one of the ways that you can do this is to get a common denominator between all of these fractions and rewrite all of them as fractions. That, however, is not the most efficient way to do it. The most efficient way to order these rational numbers is to turn them all into decimals and then order the decimals. So I'm going to go out and grab my calculator. And with my calculator, I'm just going to turn all of those fractions into decimals. So 3 divided by 8 to a decimal is 0.375. And then 4/9 as a decimal is 0.4 repeating. 7/12, we'll do 7 divided by 12, is 0.583 repeating. Okay, and you'll notice here that this calculator stops at a 3 because it can only hold a certain number of digits, but that 3 continues on and on and on and on and on. And then finally, 7/15, we have to get that as a decimal, so we do 7 divided by 15, and we get 0.46. 666. And notice this 7 here at the end. What this calculator has done is it has rounded the last digit. This is 0.46 repeating, but this last digit has been rounded up to a 7. So I'm going to write this as 0.46 repeating, like that. And now, to order my fractions, I just have to order my decimals that I have. So 0.375, I'm looking at the digit in the tenths place first. The 0.3 is smaller than 0.4, 0.5, or 0.4. So 0.375, or 3/8, is the smallest of my fractions. Then I'm looking next at the 0.4. Well, I've got 0.4 and 0.4. Those are the same at the tenths place, so I have to go to the next digit. And this next digit here is a 4. The next digit here is a 6. So the 4 is less than 6. So 4/9 is smaller than 7/15. So 4/9 is next when I'm going in order from least to greatest. And then after 0.44 repeating comes 0.46, which is repeating 6. So 7/15 is next in my list of order. And finally, 0.5 is the biggest of those decimals, so 7/12 is the largest of my rational numbers. Now, similarly here, some of these are already decimals, so 0.6 repeating, 0.84. Now I have to turn 87/100 into a decimal. Well, if we just read that 87/100, that tells us what our decimal is. 87/100, 0.87 is our decimal. 1 7/9, I know that is going to be 1 point because the 1 is the whole number, and then 7/9 as a decimal is 7 repeating. 11/16, I'm going to have to use my calculator. 11 divided by 16, and that's 0.6875. And finally, we've got here 2.5 repeating. I guess I didn't have to rewrite that. So comparing things decimal place by decimal place, going from least to greatest. Well, I've got 0.06, 0.08, or 0.8, 0.6, 0.8, 0.8 again, 1.7, 0.6, 2.5. So right now, the least of these is the 0.6 or the 0.6. And now I have to go to my next decimal place to compare. This has 0.66. This is 0.68. So 0.66 is smaller than 0.68. So my 0.6 repeating is the smallest of my rational numbers. Next is the 11 sixteenths, because 0.68 is just a little bit bigger than 0.66, repeating. Looking on, I have a 0.8 here and a 0.8 there. Nothing else to compare with. So 0.8 and 0.8 are the same at the tenths place. I go to the next digit, 0.84 compared to 0.87. Well, 84 is less than 7, so 0.84, 0.84 is smaller than 0.87. So I have 0.84 next, and 87 one-hundredths is just a little bit bigger than 0.84. So I've got those out of the way. And 87 one-hundredths. So now I just go on to my next, 1 7/9. Well, 1 is less than 2, so I can just compare at the whole number level. And I have 1 7/9 and 2.5 repeating. So I have just organized my rational numbers in order from least to greatest by comparing the decimals. Good luck.